Hey everyone, over the past year I've bought a couple of new graphics cards and also a few new power supply units. Now some of those power supply units are ATX 3.0 and some of them are ATX 3.1. And basically I wanted to do this video because knowing which power supply unit to choose is really complex sometimes, especially because ATX 3.1 power supply units are marketed as being better than ATX 3.0, but in some cases ATX 3.0 ones can actually be better than 3.1 ones, which gets completely confusing. So let's dive into the details by firstly explaining what ATX 3.0 is. So this is ATX 3.0, and this is a step up from the ATX 2.x power supply units. And a big part of the change was, of course, the 12 volt power connector, which Nvidia started playing around with on the 30 series, but then obviously introduced fully with the formal spec with the 40 and the 50 series. You know, the higher end cards use that. And actually that was the big change that we all know and love and heard all about the melting stories and everything else. But there were some other smaller changes as well when moving from ATX 2.4 to 3.0. For example, ATX 3.0 and 3.1 power supply units are more efficient at lower levels of load. And remember, the most power supply units aren't going to be completely maxed out. Even when you're gaming, it's unlikely that, you know, your CPU and your RAM and your motherboard and your graphics card and everything is using the maximum power open to it. There's always going to be some headroom. So ATX 3.0 and 3.1 power supply units are more, you know, energy efficient compared to the older ATX 2.x lineup. So that's a fairly good, albeit minor, reason why you might want to upgrade your power supply unit. But also ATX 3.0 power supply units and 3.1 can actually handle power spikes better. So all graphics cards can actually use more power than they, you know, state. So the RTX 5090 might use above 600 watts, even though it's rated for that, you know, 600 watts being the maximum. And we've also seen Reddit threads where people have talked about the new 9070 XT, and they've said that actually sometimes that uses, you know, massive amounts of power, like 500 watts or more, which is way beyond the efficiency power rating. But that is okay, because power supply units, you know, even if you've got like a 500 watt power supply unit, it should be able to handle a transient spike above that by design. You know, that is the point of a transient spike, is it's not permanent, and the power supply unit should actually be able to handle little spikes above its rated power for a very short amount of time. And that is something that ATX 3.0 power supply units actually tightened up on, so that is quite a nice benefit. But again, it's quite a minor point. In general, people were interested in the 12 volt power, you know, change and all that, because obviously the RTX 4090 used loads of power, and then the RTX 5090 actually built on that. So obviously 12 volt power is the main thing that changed, and actually that can lead to better cable management. You know, instead of running like three separate 8-pin PCI Express cables to a graphics card, you could just get like a single 12 volt power cable, plug one end into the power supply unit, maybe, and I'll talk about that point later, and the other end into your graphics card, and then you're done. So that was a big benefit of ATX 3.0 power supply units. But then with the 40 series, there were melting stories popping up all over the internet, which was incredibly concerning. And a first user error was actually blamed. So people were being blamed for not plugging in the connector all the way, either on the power supply unit or on the GPU. And even having a tiny little like razor level of gap on the actual, between the connector and the graphics card, for example, that could have been enough to actually cause melting issues. And so the ATX 3.1 standards were actually rolled out that redesigned the connector on the female side to have shorter sensing pins and longer conductors. And that actually helped a little bit. You know, it meant that if the cable wasn't plugged in all the way, it would be better. So that is a good thing. And actually that change was made on the connector side. So if you had a power supply unit with a 12 volt power slot, that actually changed internally in there. And also graphics cards changed. So Nvidia's RTX 50 series, the higher end cards that have 12 volt power slots, they are actually 12 volt 2x6 compatible in accordance with the ATX 3.1 spec. So that's a clear win for ATX 3.1, right? You should sell off your 3.0 ones and just buy 3.1, right? And then we can end this video and go home. Well, the actual reality is slightly more confusing than that. You know, you could have an older ATX 2.0 power supply unit, and actually there's no change from the PSU side. The actual change with ATX 3.1 would have only been on the actual graphics card side. So actually, you know, simply saying ATX 3.1 is better than ATX 3.0, it's sort of correct when it comes to the female connector, but obviously that can apply to the graphics card only, because not all power supply units actually have a native slot. Now obviously, if you have an ATX 3.0 power supply unit with a native slot, then we do need to talk about that, and then I'll talk about that in just a minute. But in many other cases, if you actually had like an ATX 3.0 power supply unit, that often didn't come with a native slot. So what actually Corsair, for example, done with many of their power supply units before the ones released in the last 12 months is they actually said they were ATX 3.0 compatible, but when you actually took it out of the box, there would not be like a 12 volt power or 12 volt 2x6 slot on the power supply unit. There'd be nothing like that. And instead, what you would actually have is a Corsair official cable, which had two 8-pin ends that you would plug into your power supply unit. And then the other end would give you 12 volt power that you'd then put into your graphics card. But here's the thing. In the past, I've argued in favor of ATX 3.0 or 3.1 power supply units that have that native 12 volt slot. You know, it is easier from a cable management perspective because you just plug one end into the power supply unit, one end into the graphics card, and you're done. And that is a nice thing, and that's personally what I've been doing. However, there's been a lot more research since the RTX 50 series has carried on melting that actually shows that there's not as much safety headroom in the 12 volt power connector compared to things like the older 8-pin connector. So what that actually means is some people would actually prefer to have an older ATX 2.0 power supply unit or an ATX 3.0 power supply unit that doesn't have a native slot and instead has that cable like Corsair and many other PSU makers offer that actually has those 8-pin cables that go into the power supply unit, and then the other end actually goes into your graphics card with the 12 volt, because that actually means that you're getting more safety headroom on the power supply unit end because the 8-pin connector has more safety headroom than a native 12 volt power connector. I don't know if that completely makes sense. If it doesn't, please drop me a comment and I'll explain it more. But essentially, what I'm trying to say is that simply running out and buying like an ATX 3.0 power supply unit with a native slot, that might actually not be as safe as actually having like an older power supply unit that doesn't know anything about, you know, 12 volt power. As long as you can get an official cable from the PSU maker where you plug in 8 pins into your PSU, that could arguably be safer than both of these power supply units, which actually come with a native 12 volt slot and cable and things like that. So that's why I say that actually ATX 3.0 power supply units can be better than 3.1 ones, because in general on the market, a lot of slightly older PSUs that say they support ATX 3.0 don't have that native slot. I mean, this one does, but a lot of them, including Corsair, didn't. But a lot of the power supply units that have been updated in the past 12 months and they say they support ATX 3.1, they are the ones that have that native slot, which then, you know, has slightly less safety headroom. So in a weird way, if you're looking at a power supply unit that says it supports ATX 3.0 and then it doesn't have that native slot because it's slightly, you know, out of date, that can actually be a good thing and a safer thing, which is completely balmy, but there we go. There's also a second reason why ATX 3.0 can be better than 3.1, and it comes down to hold-up times. So it gets a bit technical, but essentially, the hold-up time refers to how long a PSU can actually continue to provide voltage to the computer after the AC power has been cut. For example, if there's a brownout or a blackout or something like that. And you might be thinking this doesn't matter too much, but actually, there will always be little tiny power outages where like your lights flicker and things like that. And actually having an ATX 3.0 power supply unit might actually put you in better stead because the holdup time on that was better than with ATX 3.1. So with 3.0, it was basically a 17 millisecond, you know, standard, meaning the power supply unit, a full load, has to sort of survive that long without incoming AC voltage. But with ATX 3.1, that was actually loosened to just 12 milliseconds, which again, in reality, you know, if you have a power cut for like half a second, both, you know, power supply units are going to shut down your computer, that's obvious. But actually, you know, ATX 3.1 is a looser standard than ATX 3.0 in this particular sense. And it gets quite confusing, but I have spoken about this topic in other videos if you wanted to drill into it in more detail. If you've got any questions though, I'm also happy for you to drop me a comment and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And other than that, thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.